Welcome to Rhythm and Word, a midweek spiritual pause from Fourth Presbyterian Church. I'm Nanette Sawyer, one of the pastors here at Fourth. Well, here we are. It is the new year, and yet we're still finishing out the Christmas season. The 12th day after Christmas is called Epiphany. On Epiphany, we celebrate the arrival of the three wise ones, the three kings or three magi, the three seekers who come bearing gifts for Jesus. They follow a star to find him. They follow the light. And there he is, a holy baby, radiant with love, peace, hope, and joy. That image of finding Jesus under a radiant star brings to my mind the beginning of the gospel according to John. In John, we don't hear about shepherds and angels, mangers and magi. Instead, John paints a powerful image of God's being in Christ. God as creator, God as word with a capital W, God as light. Let's dig into this gospel a little bit. In the beginning was the Word, John's gospel begins. The Logos. Logos is the Greek word that means word. This is the word that creates. God speaks a word at creation, let there be light. And there is light. In the beginning was the Word, John says. And he goes on to say that the Word was with God and the Word was God. Jesus is that Word, the very power of creation. God speaks Jesus. And God becomes Jesus. This is poetry, which treats words as paintbrushes, words giving color to our world, illuminating possibilities, evoking sensations and feelings. The gospel goes on. The Word was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through the Word, and without the Word, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in the Word was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overtake it. As we celebrate the birth of Jesus, the Gospel of John describes the birth of the world, in which words create, and Jesus was and is the first Word, the beginning of creation. And in this story of creation, light is in balance with darkness. The light was in the darkness, it says, and not overtaken by the darkness. The light remained, and the darkness remained. The light was in the darkness. The two were in balance. We need the light to survive, and we need the darkness of the womb to be formed and born. We need the day to live and the night to rest. Plants need the darkness of the soil for their roots to grow and to gather nutrients. And plants also need the sun to gather light and transform energy into matter, light into nourishment. Light and darkness both can also become damaging. The sun can burn us terribly. Light can blind us. Darkness can depress us or make us fearful or cause us to feel lost. It was the light in the darkness the star in the night of discovery that led the Magi to the infant Jesus. And so I wonder, what star do we follow? Words have the power to lift us up and heal us and each other. And words also have the power to hurt, to wound. With words, we can cast a vision or cause pain. Words create experience. Sometimes on Epiphany, we recognize the holiday with a practice called star words, or Epiphany stars, or star gifts. The Magi brought gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But what if your gift at this time was a word that could guide you as you enter this new year? What kind of guidance do you need? What spirit do you need to find and follow? Is it perseverance or is it rest? Perhaps it is confidence or peace, generosity or discipline, trust, mercy, joy, forgiveness, connection, wonder, or hope. What Epiphany star word would you like to follow? What gift of light do you need? I invite you to think about that. Write down your word. Draw a star around it. Meditate on it. Words have the power to create, and they can help us follow Jesus, the original Word of God, the power of creation itself. With words, we too can create. Let's close by listening again to the story of the three Magi, their journey, and their gifts. Listen. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Let's pray. O holy God, God of light and of creation, shine your light of love and hope into our hearts. Help us to live in balance with you, with our world, in all our relations. Give us wisdom and words to inspire our living so that we follow you in the way of Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, today is a new day. Go out into this world with peace in your hearts. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no person evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord our God, rejoicing in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. And may God bless you and keep you. May God make God's face to shine upon you. May God be gracious to you and give you peace, now and forevermore. Amen.